So, last week, Google released their Google I.O. yearly event. This is a yearly event that they have in the summertime. Most of the time, it's either May or June, where they speak on all of their latest products and developments, including the services that we all know and love. Now, Google have, of course, in the last couple, maybe 2 weeks, released a fair few productivity software adaptations. Now, of course, we've got the new Gmail, and some of the new Google Drive is getting a slight UI redesign, as well as Google Tasks launching and many more elements. But at Google I.O., there were two things that definitely caught my eye that I wanted to share with you guys in more detail. Now, the first of them was something called digital well-being. Now, of course, we all know it's pretty manic in everyday activities. Like, we are using our phone a lot as we go across our day, and Google definitely have caught an eye on this. According to Google's research, they've said that 70% of people actually want to, you know, strike that balance between, you know, work and life and sort of taking your phone out of the situation. Now, at the Google I.O., Samir, who actually was speaking on this topic and diving into the digital well-being, actually talked about his own experience on holiday, and it was quite a good one.
Phone, right after we got to our hotel room. She took it from me, walked over to the hotel safe, locked it inside, and turned and looked me right in the eye and said, "You get this back in 7 days when we leave."
Now, Google have, of course, paid more attention to this in the last few years. Essentially, it's a dashboard allowing you to see all of the apps that you used across the day based on hourly and daily intake. Now, it will calculate how much time you spent on your phone as well as certain applications, but it also goes a bit deeper. Now, in the application, you can actually access three real main core experiences. The first being an app timer, allowing you to set a timer on a certain application and giving you a little nudge on, okay, you've spent too much time on this application. Very similar to some of the other applications to some extent, but this would be native to Android or whatever they release on the application through notifications, allowing you, you know, a message to say, okay, you can get off this now. They also have a do not disturb mode. So let's say you have a dinner and you're like, okay, I do not want anyone to disturb me. Very similar to what we've already got on iPhone and to some extent notifications on Android. This mode will actually block any messages coming through, allowing you to have a bit of a fine-tuned experience. And the final experience is wind down. So you can either activate this on Google Home or you can actually activate this on the phone, allowing you to wind down on applications. Your phone will go into a grayscale mode and definitely shut down around certain applications, sort of reducing any stress before you go to bed on app usage. Now, it's really impressive how Google are sort of taking a leap with this. I think after the whole Facebook situation with the Facebook data, I think the people are being a bit more aware that they shouldn't be spending that much time on certain items. Now, it's definitely similar to the situation where it's like, you know, we've got, you know, McDonald's around the corner, but do we go and eat it all the time? Do we limit ourselves? And, you know, actually McDonald's sort of making an attempt. It's sort of like Google's making an attempt on this sort of invasion of our overuse of phones. So it's quite an interesting leap. Now, the second experience that I definitely wanted to mention was the new Google Assistant. They've obviously made a host of new updates, including voice activation developments, but they've also enhanced their AI, and this is something that has been a massive change. Now, last year I actually talked about AnyDo releasing this function inside the application, which allows AnyDo users to get prompted by a bot, allowing them to do activities. So for example, the bot would maybe even message you and say, can I organize the flowers that you've requested in your list and communicate with a florist about this and actually get that solved? And of course, that's an amazing function. But Google have gone a whole step further. Now, Google Assistant have released this sort of like operating system to some extent. You know, I'm no developer or anything like that, called Duplex, allowing essentially your assistant to actually have a conversation with humans, which is absolutely amazing. The footage is incredible. I'm going to link it in the description because I'm not sure about rights to the footage. So you can go and watch it. But the actual Google Assistant has a conversation with a restaurant staff member.
The call actually goes a bit differently than expected. So, take a listen.
See, how may I hear you?
Hi, I'd like to reserve a table for Wednesday the 7th.
For 7 people?
It's for 4 people.
for people when?
Next Wednesday at 6 p.m.
Oh, actually, we listed for like upper like five people. For people, you can come.
How long is the wait usually to...
Essentially, the Google Assistant, prompted by you, or in the future, they'll probably detect inside of your to-do list a command about making a reservation, for example. With their permission, they will activate a Google Assistant to call up the local restaurant that you're looking to book at, and they will actually have a conversation. And you're probably wondering, this is probably going to fall on itself, and of course, probably early editions will. But the actual conversation they recorded with very intricate details, so for example, the host was actually talking about something very unique and the Google Assistant was able to sort of battle through that and schedule the bookings, which was pretty impressive. I really applaud you to go and check that one out. But this sort of Google Assistant being able to do stuff in the background really is something that caught my attention as someone who sort of covers the latest productivity software. And I definitely think that Google AI's developments here are going to be a huge advance on everything. I've been talking a lot in the past about how Google is sort of advancing things, but this is the biggest step I think they've made towards that. Now, the Google Assistant will, of course, I think this, they said that it would be later this year, which normally means December, but it definitely is a step forward for Google and something that I would definitely look at having in the future. Like the other day, I was booking a restaurant and I came across, I actually was booking that process and calling up, and I was like, this is actually taking me potentially like 7-8 minutes. And of course, those little situations, you know, adding up hair appointments or reservations, things like that, can obviously add up. And I think this is such a nice beginning point for Google Assistant, but hopefully it all works really smoothly. Anyway, guys, I thought that was quite interesting. It personally was interesting for me, seeing Google sort of make those developments. Let me know in the comments how you think Google will take in this space and sort of make the leaps forward, because I really love to hear your opinion. Pop them in the comments below. But apart from that, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe if you're brand new, because we put out regular videos about productivity software and content, so I'm sure you'll find this enjoyable. But anyway, guys, Google are doing cool things, so definitely worth keeping an eye on them.